every day when I wake up. I can see his mercies all around me, and in every circumstance, his plans for me is to succeed.
Grace and peace, and good morning to each and every one of you. Welcome to Fresh Start. This is Pastor Daryl Fair, and I'm grateful and thankful that God has given us a wonderful opportunity to begin a brand new day together. I want to remind all of us of Lamentations chapter number 3 and verse number 23, where the Bible says that the mercies of God are renewed every single morning. Great is his faithfulness to you and I. This is why we call this Fresh Start, because every day that we wake up, it is a day that God has blessed us with his grace and his mercy. For the month of September, of course, we've been spending our time under the heading 30 Days of Prayer, and we've been targeting prayer targets or focus throughout this month so far. And as God continues to lead us, I'm praying that we're gaining knowledge and understanding, which brings us to today's passage of scripture. John chapter number 9, verses 1, 2, and 3. The Bible says, "And as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was blind from his birth. And his disciples asked him, saying, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Jesus answered, Neither hath this man sinned, nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him." Our prayer focus for today is a prayer for understanding. A prayer for understanding. Part of the thought pattern of that day and time was that if anyone was born with some type of deficiency or some type of ailment or some type of quote unquote disfigurement, it was solely because the parents had committed some type of sin. And because of that, their child was born with some type of illness or some type of hindrance or some type of being, as we say today, differently abled. Back then, it was considered more of an issue and or a problem. And so the idea is, if you're born this way, your parents must have done something. So the disciples asked the question, "Lord, who sinned?" It's kind of nosy of them, if you ask me. Jesus is walking by and he sees a man that's born blind. And the disciples want to know which one of the parents sinned. Now that's a the different kind of, I don't know if you ever thought about that before in reading this particular passage of scripture, how inconsiderate and nosy the disciples must have been to target this man that was born blind, only to ask Jesus the question, which one sinned that this person was born blind? And Jesus basically answers the question, no one sinned. Sin did not cause this man to be born blind, but this person was born blind that the works of God should be made manifest in him. You know, it's easy to go through something, I believe, easier, I should say, to go through some things when you know the reason why. It's when we don't know why we deal with what we deal with and go through as long as we go through and what we go through that we find it difficult, I think, to navigate through difficulty. But when you know why, I think it becomes a little easier to deal with what you deal with because you know why. And so our prayer this morning is a prayer for understanding. And here's the thing, because we're going to deal with this for 2 days. The understanding that God gives to us may not be what we want to hear, but at least it gives us a greater understanding, greater information, greater insight as to the why. That's really what the disciples, the nosy disciples, were really asking. Why? Why was this guy born blind? Who did something that this man was born blind? And so my prayer today for you, and I want to challenge and encourage you to pray along this line, that God would give you an understanding. We know from yesterday we were talking about how God could, and how we should pray that God would help us as we go through the things that we go through, and a prayer for strength. But today we're praying for understanding. We're praying for understanding. God, give me insight to the why. And as God gives us insight, may the insight that He gives you and I today give us clarity for tomorrow. God willing, God be our help and strength. I'll see you in the morning. God bless. Gospel, this is the good news. Tell everybody how He saved you. This is the gospel. Come here, the good news. Tell everybody there's a God that loves you.